Hello everyone, this is the second chapter of the Excelize tutorials, section 6. In this section, I will show you how to read the workbook and the worksheet by Excelize, and how to calculate the formula. I have created a workbook for student exam score in the second chapter, section 2. In this section, I will read that workbook by Excelize. You will learn 12 Excelize functions by this example. At first, I will show you how to open the encrypted workbook with the password, how to get all worksheet names in the workbook, and get the default worksheet index. Create a directory named 2.6 in the tutorial directory, and put the student exam score workbook in this directory. Let's take a look at this workbook. There are two worksheets, transcript and the charsheet in the workbook. Open the project in the Visual Studio Code Editor, and create a source code with the Go extension named main.go. Import the format library and the Excelize library. Create the main function and open the book1.xlsx by the open file function provided by Excelize. Receiving and checking the error. Use defer to close the workbook when the main function returns. Open the terminal. Run go mod init command to create a new module rooted in the current directory, and run go mod tidy to add any missing module requirements necessary to build the current module's packages and dependencies. I will show you how to open the encrypted workbook with a password. First, set the password protection for the workbook. The password is the password. Specify the password file in the options parameter of the open file function to decrypt the workbook. Next, reading the worksheet name list. Get a worksheet index and name by the getSheetList function. Print in the worksheet index and name. Save the code and run the program in the terminal. You can see that the worksheet index and name have been output in order. If I need to get the active sheet name, using the getActiveSheetIndex function to get the ActiveSheet index first, and then find the sheet name in the sheet list by sheet index. Print the ActiveSheet name, save the code, and run the program. You can see the ActiveSheet name. Next, I will show you how to read the merged cells, and how to search the cell value in the worksheet. Get the merged cells in the ActiveSheet by the getMergedCells function provided by Excelize. Receiving and checking the error, getting the merged cells as merged cells variable, and traversing the merged cells, print the upper left and the bottom right cells coordinates of each merged cells range. Save the code and run the program. You can see the 4 merged cells range has been printed out. Then search the cell in the worksheet with specified cell value by the search sheet function. The first parameter is the worksheet name. The second parameter is the lookup cell value. Receiving and checking the error. Traversing the search result variable, split with a comma symbol and print the cell coordinates of the search result. Save the code and run the program. It found 2 cells in the worksheet with the value 75. In addition, the search sheet function supports the search cell in the worksheet with regular expression. Specify the second parameter of the search sheet function as a regular expression, turn on the regular search mode. Search in the worksheet for the cell value starting with 7. Print the search result. Save the code and run the program in the terminal. You can see that the cell's coordinates in the search result has been output. Then read all the cells value in the worksheet by the getRows function. Receiving and checking the error. Store the two-dimensional array as variable rows. It stores the value of each cell row by row, traverses rows to get each row of cells, and traverses the row to get each cell of the row. Print the value of each cell. Output the new line after the end of each row. Save the code and run the program in the terminal. All cells value in the worksheet has been printed out. Next, let's learn how to calculate the cell formula result, get cell comments, and get the column weights. The cells in the range K4 to K9 was a formula cell. The cell value read in empty if the cell has no calculation result cache. To calculate the cell formula result, I need to prepare the cell coordinates first. Using the row index R and column index C when traversing the rows and columns to prepare the cell coordinates. Get the coordinates with the coordinates to cell name function we learned in previous section, and print the cell coordinates, save the code, and run the program. You can see that the cell coordinates of the formula cell has been printed out. Then calculate the formula result by the calcCellValue function with the specified worksheet name and the cell coordinates. Receiving and checking the error, save the code and run the program. The formula result has been calculated. Then get cell comments in the worksheet by the getComments function. It returns a map with the worksheet name and the comments array. Traverse the map to get the worksheet name as a sheet name and the comments list on each worksheet, and then traverse the comments to get each comment. Print the worksheet name, the author of the comment, and the comment text. Save the code and run the program. You can see the cell comment has been printed out. Next, get the column width by the getColumnViz function. The first parameter is the worksheet name. The second parameter is the column name. Receiving and checking the error. Get and print the width of the column A. Save the code and run the program. The width of the column A has been printed out. Then get the width of column G with the getColumnViz again, and print the value of the variable width. Save the code and run the program. You can see the width of column G. Next, I will show you how to get the height of the row, how to extract the images from the workbook, and how to get the default font of the workbook. Get the height of the row by the getRowHeight function provided by Excelize. The first parameter is the worksheet name. The second parameter is the row number. Receiving and checking the error. Printing the height of the first row. Save the code and run the program. The height of the first row has been printed out. We can use the getPicture function to extract image in the workbook with the specified worksheet name and the cell coordinates when inserting the image. The function has three return values, which were the name of the image, image content represented in byte array data type, and the error. Checking the error, printing the name and the size of the image in bytes. Save the code and running the program. The image in the workbook has been extracted. Next, get the default font of the workbook by the getDefaultFont function. Print the default font of the workbook. Save the code and run the program in the terminal. You can see the default font of this workbook was Calibri. Okay, that's it for this video. If you liked it, please give me a thumbs up. If you have any questions, please comment below. And welcome to subscribe and ring the bell so you can get notified anytime we release new content. Thanks for watching and thank you for choosing Excelize.